Welcome to the spookiest presentation, starring Celiac Disease. Wow, isn't that scary? What a spooky cartoon.
So what is celiac disease? Celiac disease is an autoimmune disorder that is caused by the inability to properly digest gluten. It is a multi-system disorder. However, the organ that is affected is the small intestine, as it functions to absorb and digest nutrients. Gluten ingestion in those affected with celiac disease can cause damage to the small intestine. It can develop at any age once a person starts ingesting food or medicine that contains gluten. Celiac disease is genetic. Having a family member with celiac increases the risk for someone in a younger generation. If you have a first-degree relative with celiac, you have a 1 in 10 risk for that disease. And celiac is also referred to as celiac sprue, or gluten sensitivity enteropathy.
Let's take a look at how celiac disease can cause an icky immune response. Normally, the immune system functions to protect our body from foreign invaders. The immune system in a person with celiac disease sees gluten as a foreign invader and decides to attack it. Gluten is a protein found in wheat, barley, and rye. When a person with celiac disease ingests it, the body creates an immune response attacking the small intestine. The small finger-like villi projections that line the small intestine are attacked and become damaged, making them unable to perform their normal function of nutrient absorption. In the picture on the left, you can see the large difference in the small intestine of a person with celiac disease and the healthy intestine.
In celiac disease, the immune system activates innate immunity, which leads to pro-inflammatory changes and responses. So when gluten peptides are ingested, they are transported to the mucosal lamina propria. Here, the gluten peptides are deaminated by TTG2, or anti-tissue transglutaminase 2, and they strongly bind to human leukocyte antigens on antigen-presenting cells. This is what causes the inflammatory response in the body from the immune system, and the immune system then attacks the small intestine, and this leads to small intestine enteropathy. IELs infiltrate the epithelial barrier, and they cause disruption here. This causes increased transfer of immunogenic gluten peptides. Pro-inflammatory pathways become activated, and this causes atrophy of the microvilli in the small intestine and production of antibodies against intestinal TTG2, or the anti-tissue transglutaminase.
Some risk factors. Celiac disease can affect men and women of all ages and races. According to BeyondCeliac.org, an estimated 1 in 133 Americans, or about 1% of the population, has celiac disease. Some factors can put you at a higher risk for getting celiac disease. Genetically, it's more common in those with a family history of the disease. It occurs up to 5 to 10% of family members of people diagnosed with celiac disease. The genes HLA-DQ2 and HLA-DQ8, 95% of people diagnosed have the HLA-DQ2 gene, and 5% have the HLA-DQ8 gene. Having the gene puts you at a higher risk, but does not mean that you will have the disease. Other autoimmune disorders makes you more likely to develop another type of autoimmune disease when you have celiac disease.
Let's take a look at the organ that celiac disease affects the most, which is the small intestine. The small intestine is lined with tiny hair-like projections called microvilli. For those with celiac disease, eating gluten causes an immune response in the small intestine, and over time it will cause damage to the microvilli, preventing it from absorbing any nutrients. Inflammation and swelling of the intestines can also occur. The villi flatten out, or they can even disappear due to the body's immune response to eating gluten. When the microvilli do flatten out and lose their shape, this leads to damage to the intestinal lining overall. So in the picture above, you can see how the microvilli are flattened due to the damage done by celiac disease, and you can see that the nutrients aren't absorbed very well.
Some symptoms that can occur with celiac disease are anemia, and this occurs in the area of the small intestine where iron is absorbed and is damaged because the villi in the intestine cannot absorb anything or function as they normally would, leading to iron deficiency, which could lead to anemia. You also have digestive problems, bloating or gas, constipation. You could have delayed growth in children due to a lack of vitamins and nutrients because they are not able to absorb anything in their small intestine. You can have abdominal pain, and this can be associated with bloating and gas. You can have anxiety, defects in enamel formation, malnutrition, again due to not being able to absorb anything, depression, diarrhea, weight loss, which is often unexplained in someone who is not diagnosed yet, and nausea and vomiting can also occur.
For diagnosis, there are two different types of blood tests that can be performed. You can have a serological test, and this test looks for antibodies in the patient's blood. If certain antibodies are elevated in the blood, it can signal an immune reaction to gluten. Genetic testing can also be done. Testing for human leukocyte antigens, HLA-DQ2 and HLA-DQ8, they can rule out celiac disease. If these tests indicate for celiac disease, then the doctor will most likely perform an endoscopy or a capsule endoscopy. An endoscopy is a long tube with a tiny camera and then it passes through the throat to view the small intestine and examine for damage of the microvilli within the small intestine. In a capsule endoscopy, there is a tiny wireless camera that is inside a vitamin-sized capsule which you swallow. The mini camera will then take thousands of pictures of the small intestine. That will then transmit to the recorder for then it to be viewed.
It's time to take a look at some trick or treatments for celiac disease. So what's encouraged is a strict gluten-free diet. Also, it is encouraged to see a dietitian. Even trace amounts of gluten can be damaging to the body. Foods and beverages with no more than 20 parts per million of gluten content is allowed. The villi in the small intestine require several months to years to heal. Adult healing can take much longer and last 2 to 3 years, while compared to children, the villi can heal in approximately 6 months. Also, vitamin and mineral supplementation can be affected. It is common to see deficiencies in fiber, iron, calcium, zinc, magnesium, folate, niacin, vitamin B12, vitamin D, and riboflavin. It is also common to see calories and proteins deficient. Gluten-free multivitamins can also be given as a form of therapy in celiac disease.
With celiac disease could come a lot of other associated health problems. Celiac disease can lead to malnutrition, osteoporosis, infertility, and various intestinal cancers. It is also common in people with other autoimmune disorders, such as thyroid disease, liver disease, type 1 diabetes, lupus, and rheumatoid arthritis.
Up next, we have some spine-chilling statistics. Many times, it's hard to figure out if the symptoms of celiac disease, such as stomach pains and excessive diarrhea, are linked to CD. That's why 83% of Americans with celiac disease are misdiagnosed. As you increase in age, the chances of developing an autoimmune disorder, such as celiac disease, increases. So you have a 16.7% chance of developing celiac disease between the ages of 4 to 12 years old, compared to being over the age of 20 years old, which is 34%. On average, it takes an American around 4 years to be diagnosed with celiac disease. During these 4 years, you are increasing the risk of developing another immune disorder.
Are y'all ready for some freaky fun facts?
Yes.
Okay. There are over 300 symptoms for celiac disease, but they vary in each person. Various things that can cause celiac symptoms to appear, such as overwhelming stress, pregnancy, recent surgery, physical trauma or injury, an infection, and childbirth. A person normally waits approximately 6 to 10 years for a correct diagnosis of celiac disease. Celiac is more common in people who are white, obese, have type 1 diabetes, or have European ancestors. More children are diagnosed with celiac than Crohn's, ulcerative colitis, and cystic fibrosis. If not diagnosed in a timely manner, celiac can lead to type 1 diabetes, intestinal cancers, miscarriage, infertility, osteoporosis, thyroid disorders, multiple sclerosis, anemia, and epilepsy.
Now we have a cannibalistic case study. A 10-year-old boy presented to the ER with stomach discomfort and vomiting for the past 5 days. He also said that he had intermittent constipation. His mother, who had blood on her shirt and shoes, said to the attending doctor that they had been eating limbs of campers who walked on their land 2 weeks ago. She said that she coated the legs and arms with breadcrumbs, ooh, yummy, and fried them to make them tender to eat. The sister of the patient, who also had celiac disease, went through the same problem last summer when the family prepared the brains of mountain bikers the same way. Blood tests were conducted, and once they resulted, the A tissue transglutaminase titer was 5 times the upper limit of a normal level. This indicated celiac disease along with the symptoms presented, which confirmed the diagnosis.